Ooh, it's a teleportation magic! Yo, it's your boy Betty. Now, quick disclaimer, what you're about to see is basically a follow-on from me re-watching episode 3 of Overlord. So we are about to watch episode 4 right now. I was basically a little confused. It's been a couple of, I think, weeks, maybe even a month since I last watched the last episode. So obviously I have just re-watched it, so I'm still asking a lot of questions, but excited nonetheless, as you will see. So of course, yeah, hit the like and the subscribe button, of course, if you enjoyed the video. And yeah, let's get right into it. Okay. Of the sunlit scripture. Hi. Gazef. That's the head warrior, right? Contains the miracle of the gloves. This guy does look kind of beast, you know. Okay, so they're religious zealot. Whoa, his eyes. Wait, did he just change? This eye color just changed, yeah. Ooh, he looks dope. Obviously, we're not watching the opening OSTs yet. We are going to skip this one and carry on. One of the six scriptures. Hey, so this episode is gonna snap, right? Because we got some fights coming up. I didn't know that this was gonna be a bit of a battle-esque anime. It's nice, man. Why are you always saying your name on the full? On the full, in full. What's that? He's getting a lot of praise, Momongo, right now from this guy. I should be singing the same to you. But if he's a head warrior, he should be a bit of a beast, I guess, right? Small animals. Because I got this. We don't need him. Why don't summon more dead knights and just have them, like, do the fighting for you? Let's go, my dude. Oh yeah, they were sorcerers or something. That dude looked kind of creepy. Wow. Ooh. What is that? It kind of gives me like, it's really weird. I don't know. It's like a spirit or something. But it's like a robot spirit. It's so weird. Ooh, they have abilities! Focus Battle. Ooh, okay. Do you know what? That gave me, that actually gave me Yu-Gi-Oh vibes. I'm not gonna lie, yeah. That monster looked like a maybe I've been playing too much Yu-Gi-Oh. But that monster looked like a Yu-Gi-Oh character, like a Yu-Gi-Oh monster. And the way that it was, like, it got disintegrated was almost like it got defeated in a Yu-Gi-Oh battle. Like, I don't know why. But that's just the vibes I got. One true villain, don't you agree? And now he's activated his trap card, allowing him to summon more from his deck, basically. I've been playing too much Yu-Gi-Oh. He wants you though. Like, he wants the smite. That was quite dope, man. So yeah, this guy has some actual abilities, martial art.
flow acceleration. Ooh, the animation looked kind of clean too. Yeah, man, you just gotta believe. Attack skills. So is it similar to like slime in the sense that they collect abilities and skills and... But is it mainly like Maho? You know? My dude can just keep summoning these guys from nowhere. Oh, it's the miracle from God, isn't it? Oh, Nemo. So if he's using this magical item from the church, it's not gonna be good. Because he could just keep summoning these monsters who aren't really alive, right? So he's trying to defend himself. Oh, yeah, he can't. It's like one versus Baron. Damn! Honestly, though, does this not give you a bit of Yu-Gi-Oh vibes? Like, even their swords gives me Swords of Revealing Light vibes. I don't know, man. Maybe I just, again, got it in my head too much, but... Oh? Nah, he won't go out like this, right? He's a dope character, literally got only, like, only introduced last step. Gazefustronov. Ooh, what a name! Gazefustronov. Why do people always say this? It's like, I'll be nice, I'll just make sure you die a painless death. It's like, what are you trying to achieve with that? Dope. Wait, what? Ooh, it was a teleportation magic! So they switched. I want him to go head up though. I want him to see the actual battle. Like, I want to see the scale of what this could potentially be. Yeah, he's a villain. He's a villain. Let's see what the angels do then. Obviously, he's not done. Hey, yo. Completely nullifies the physical attacks? Ah, low leveled weapons. Okay. I like that they included that caveat so that, you know, in the future we'll actually see that someone will be able to hurt him. Yeah, so, Ice, explain to me Idrisil then. Is Idrisil the old rendition of the game? Obviously, they're in this new rendition where, yeah, they have the guild, he's Momonga, you know, all of that stuff, right? But he keeps referencing Idrisil, like, you know, magic from Idrisil, like, gold coins from Idrisil. So for me, in my mind, I was like, Idrisil was like the previous version of the game, like, kind of thinking of this as like a sequel, right? Almost like a version of like a, I don't know, like a Fortnite with Fortnite 2, for instance. I know there's not a Fortnite 2, but, you know, roll with it here for this analogy. But is Idrisil kind of like that, like a pre-installment of the game, basically? And is that why he keeps referencing to Idrisil in the way that he does about, you know, things being from there and all of that sort of stuff? Because that does still throw me off. Oh, actually, it wasn't even his magic though, really, because it was the church who gave him that miracle of God, right? He's like, I got this, babe. I'll bay, though. Damn! Literally wipes him out within a second. So while the game making create like guilds, so while the Well, that game they can create guilds of their own making, but you have to grind for that. But some elements of the game he was in is in this world. Right, okay. So it was like another game, basically. But similar in the sense that you had guilds, it's just the grind was a lot more difficult. Hence why he is so OP now, because he's grinded through this pre-installment of the game, I'm guessing. Almost like a beta version, I guess, right? Instead of it being like a, you know, Fortnite 1 and Fortnite 2, maybe it's like a beta. A server was opened up for like a few people to play. They grinded, got their levels up, and then the official game came out. And this is the official game that he's been teleported to. Damn! Didn't have to do him like that. She's a beast. Wow. Wow. Hey, you know what? She's a ride or die, man. She is. You do need an Albedo in your life, you know. She kind of gives me Shion vibes from Slime. Yori yori. Hellflame, just like I'll stop referencing other anime. Okay, I'll stop. sometimes it can get a bit annoying, so I'll stop. But I see the comparisons there, the similarities rather. Oh, I've still got my stone. Highest level angel? Oh really? Idrisil items. They're not in the game, they're in another world. But the other world is based on this game? Am I right in thinking that? Because I'm guessing that... Because I'm guessing that's what he was questioning in episode 1. It was like, you know, these characters who... Yeah, because I guess that was what he was questioning in episode 1, where it was like, these characters seem to have their like more of personality than they did initially when we used to play the game. So is it that, like, they, you know, that they, obviously, this game is real in real world, but he's been transported to another reality where the game is actually the universe, like, the game is that reality kind of thing, and that's what's actually going on. It's like real life to him, but in a different body. Right, so yeah, he has been kind of like... transported into this other world, and I guess he's inhabited the character he used to be utilizing when obviously playing a character from his own reality. So yeah, he's only really traveled dimensions, I guess. That actually explains a lot and makes a lot more sense. That makes a lot more sense and adds a lot more clarity, actually. So I appreciate that. Welcome to the family. Thank you for the clarity and a bit of context there as well. I was definitely a little bit, you know, a little bit lost, so I appreciate it. And yeah, anyway, welcome to the family. Dominion Authority. Damn. I like the angel designs, actually. They look kind of dope. He looks crazed, though. Nani? Holy smite. This is 7th tier magic. Oh wait, but he's got way more levels to his magic. From my memory. Nah, I'm a monger savage, man. This is pain. He's sounding like Madara right now. It's been ages since I've bled. Oh no, Albedo's gone freak. Oh, you've done it now. I would have let her, you know. I would have been like, you know, like, I kind of can't be asked. Just go. I'm so lazy. I would have been like, alright, Alvedo, you do it. Yeah, I can't be asked. just did it for me. Wow, he's OP. He's OP. We literally just send the dude to another dimension. Come me. Einzul Goon. He's so dope. Wow. Wow! Only like normal people can reach tier 2 of magic. If you're really good, you can reach tier 3 in this world. And that guy just said that he used tier 7. So that just goes to show you how powerful Momonga actually is. That's insane. So what would they class themselves? Because I'm guessing they're not demons, right? Facts. I did say it never ends well for people who always say that. It just never does. It's like, why say all that stuff? You're not gonna do it. King Kappa. Hey, you know, she's jokes, man. This animation is actually really good, you know. Because they're good enough to even include little things like them winking while having conversations. A lot of times, like, animes actually forget that. But I've noticed that like, they include little things like that. Like, even just, like, her eyes being kind of watery there. I don't know if you noticed, but, like, there's little... I don't know, there's just little inclusions of things that, like, small details, but really add to the overall picture. Why you like that? Trying to get me banned on Twitch, man, dang. Yeah. Changed your name? Okay. That makes a lot more sense. I had that question like in episode 3. I was like, Ayn's all going. Like, how comes he's going by that name when his name has always been Momonga to us? But he's changed his name. So I'm guessing when they asked him his name, he decided, okay, this is what I'm going to introduce myself as to the world. Ayn's all going. That makes total sense. I just realized I took my jacket. I don't even remember when I took that off. I literally don't even remember. That's so funny. But okay, that explains a lot. Ayn's. Okay, we'll call him Ayn's now instead of Momonga. But I do like Momonga though. She really a ride or die, man. Banzai! We should give ourselves completely. God damn. Wow. Talk about loyalty. Overlord, they said it! They said it! Nah, they've got me hyped for this anime now. I feel like I'm actually hooked. Like I'm in. You know what I mean? Sometimes it takes like a couple of episodes for me to get into like a show, but like now I'm like, yeah, I'm interested. I'm curious to see where this goes. Right, because this is another question I had. Like, was he the only person really, or were there other people? Don't. I'm glad we did a double reaction finally. Like, we actually watched two episodes here with episodes 3 and episodes 4, and it did not disappoint. Like, I'm definitely, like, the show is building up a lot of, I don't know, man. Just, I guess, a lot of buy-in from me, a lot of investment. And the way they're doing that is through the world building, is through, you know, the lore, the backstory, the history around this world and the people and how they behave. The characters are very, you know, nuanced, and I like that. But I also like how, like the animation definitely fuels the overall storytelling, the overall elements that are kind of included in this story. Like I said, the little small details included in, you know, Moments Rare, for instance, Albedo's talking to the person she absolutely basically loves and is kind of mentally possessed by. Not possessed, but you know what I mean, right? Emotionally possessed, I guess, is probably a better way to put it. They really are able to portray that, even like when that head warrior was flying you know, against that mage, for instance, you know, his stress, his worries, like, kind of came through the expressions, through the way that he was kind of, you know, the for instance, sweat was kind of, you know, animated. It was all done really, really well, and I'm definitely really enjoying this show. But, like, yeah, let's get to the review portion, and let's dissect. Are you saying I can watch the ending if I wanted to? Oh, there's more. Wait. I didn't realize there was more. Yeah. Tell everyone about your conversation with Lord Irons. Untouched box of treasures. Alright, okay. The world is the box of treasures. Okay, cool. I completely misread that. Cool. That was interesting that they included that right after the, you know, the ending. But yeah, let's get to the review portion and let's dissect. Absolutely loving this show. So again, Ice, shout out to you for that recommendation. Definitely a nice follow on, especially after finishing Slime. So really appreciate it. This show is absolutely fire. I love the main character and I really like the people he surrounded himself with. I think I really like Albedo. I think that's what I'm saying. I think that's why I'm saying that. But also the hero warrior, the, you know, the head warrior. What's his name? Grazovstronov? I've already butchered that name, so apologies. But he was dope and his introduction was really, really cool, and hopefully he'll be a character that we'll see kind of formulate a stronger bond with Momonga with. I can't get over that name. It's so easy to say. It's got a nice ring to it. It's nice. It's gonna be a while. It's gonna take some time, okay? So just bear with me on that one. But really enjoyed it, of course. Let me know what you guys thought and definitely drop those thoughts down in the comment section. Of course, if you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit the like button. But if you're a new viewer, definitely hit the subscribe button and come join the Betty gang as well as the Twitch, because we definitely want you here. But most importantly, for everyone who's just been showing you a lot of love, showing me a lot of love. Well, I guess, you know, if they're showing you a lot of love as well, that's great. But thank you as always. This, of course, is your boy Betty, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.
Started with some scraps and now I'm running my own company. Every day is Sunday cause my everyday is sucker free. Gastronomic with economics, I'm whipping chemistry. I can't spit any product, fucking up the industry. Told you from the start that I will come up and I'll kill this shit. Money on my brain and run around like it got membership. Popping on some Billy, trying to hang out where the ceiling is.